Hey, hey everyone, and welcome to the fourth part of this tutorial series. In the last three parts, we configured a car, implemented a controller that uses Polaris AI, and discussed the state machine setup of the roundabout scene. However, we noticed a problem in the last part. The cars still crash when entering the roundabout. They don't give forefart. This is a problem though. After all, we don't want the agents to behave like me when playing GTA. Now, why don't we just use aim reduction? The problem is simple. Even when using velocity prediction, the magnitudes are dependent on the distance in all possible directions. This is not what we want because if we increase the radius, the agent brakes earlier on the one hand, but waits longer before driving again on the other hand. What we want is a parameter that defines how far another car can be away before the agent starts to slow down. As soon as the other car has passed the agent, it should immediately start moving again. This is indeed possible, it is just not that obvious. We just have to design a suitable sensor. Actually, we just need one receptor pointing forward. So we create a new sensor, choose one receptor, use plane XZ and create a line. What we want to achieve is that our car slows down if something is in the direction the receptor is facing. The sensor can be interpreted as the driver's head. He or she looks in the direction where other cars have the right of way. So if you deactivate the sensor randomly, you could in fact simulate f**ks who frequently look at their smartphone. Okay, but that leaves us with an obvious problem. We have two different sensors now. We still need the setup from part 3 of our tutorial, because this sensor tells the car where to move to. The solution is simple. Just use two aim context instances. After all, what restricts us not to combine information of multiple aim context results in a controller? First, let's look at the AI priority road game object. Here we see a very simple setup using one objective, our custom sensor, and an instance of aimSeek. The sensitivity offset parameter is especially important here, since it defines the angle of our thought view cone. The outer radius defines the range as always. Please don't mind the perceiver connector, this is just a component that we had to provide since we cannot use tag in the package. Now we have to somehow combine the knowledge of both context instances. This is done in our controller. We add the fields we need, the second context, the animator. The animator is necessary to check if we are in the right state to use the priority context. Back in fixed update, we start by checking if the second context is available. We define a field that determines if we use the priority logic or not. We then set it to true because we assume that someone else has the right of way. If a state machine is present, we can further check if the agent actually has priority or not. This is the case if the change parameter has a value of -1. So set the field false if the state is not -1. This is of course dependent on the state machine configuration. Then we can check the result of our context for priority and change the input acceleration accordingly. For simplicity's sake, we choose a hard threshold here. Smoother functions should improve the behavior. That's that. Now we actually have to fix the setup like this. but since we are lazy computer scientists, we use a shortcut here and simply change to the same state we have in the package, since it is now the same. Now let's conclude and see what we can take away from this video. Setting up such complex simulations is a difficult process, but not impossible if you keep some things in mind. First, complex scenarios can be mastered using state machines. Second, a controller can use a lot of different influences to make the final movement, not just one context. Third, setting up physical agents like cars, aircrafts, and similar things can be very difficult, as they require assistance systems. Those systems are necessary, but have nothing to do with Polaris AI. You always have to think, how can I convert a direction into a command for control surfaces or a steering wheel in this case? One last word of advice regarding the multi-context setup. This example worked so well, since we only used the magnitude of the second context and not the direction. As we said, it is possible to mix multiple directions to a final direction. However, keep in mind that mixing multiple directions leads to the same problem classical steering has. If you're not careful, you might easily lead your agents into deadlocks. We hope that information helped to better understand how complex physics-based agents work. So stay tuned for more content. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.